Some kind of neat.
And I'm back. On the last installment, we did three more Cartoon Eliminator races, and now we're gonna do three more Cartoon Eliminator races with the same squad, Callum. We're gonna use the same squad. So we did the Courage one, we did the Chicken one, we did the I Am Weasel one, we did the Johnny Bravo one. We're gonna do the Powerpuff Girls one, and it's gonna be race one. Man, I miss OG Powerpuff Girls. I will be salty about that until the end of time. Because you can't reboot something and, like, drop it seven demographics. Like, when I was watching Powerpuff Girls, I was, like, I don't know, five or six. And fucking, they were beating each people up and blood everywhere. And there was, like, a homoerotic devil dude. And there was, you know, tons of explosions. And Sedusa. Sedusa was one of the best villains because she was a hot lady who seduced people and killed them. What a great enemy. Why don't they bring back Sedusa in the reboot? Oh, yeah, because people will get mad. They'll be like, that's demeaning. And then, no, she is like Medusa, as in she attracts and kills people, but she seduces them and makes them weak so that they can be killed. Or so that they betray their friends or whatever. Also, hi, Eyeballman. Also, another great thing about the original one was freaking Miss Bellum, because as a whole bunch of YouTubers have pointed out, which I agree with, the reason that the creators of the reboot took Miss Bellum out is because, quote, oh, she was, like, not a good standard for what we wanted to, like, portray in the reboot for, like, the girl characters. Yet, literally, she's the smartest and coolest of all the Powerpuff Girls characters. She saves the day. She's pretty much the mayor, because the mayor is useless. So, you know, she does the work of the mayor, essentially. Even though she's just the secretary. So that's why Miss Bellum's a great character. Another great character, even like the shitty characters like Mitch and the Elmer Glue Kid, they're better than half the characters in the reboot. Also, in the reboot, half the characters don't even look like they belong in the Powerpuff Girls universe. Also, why aren't they in kindergarten? They used it as an excuse for like Pokey Oaks is closed because they blew it up. Well, here's the thing. Why don't they just have an episode when they rebuild Pokey Oaks and then they're in Pokey Oaks again? That would make more sense than, oh, now we're in elementary school and all these kids are being dumb and blah, blah, blah. It's silly. I don't know. I'm just really salty over reboots of things from my childhood. Like, Shaolin Chronicles sucked. I loved Shaolin Showdown, and when they announced Shaolin Chronicles on Disney XD, I was like, oh shit, son. And then I realized it was like a Canadian company that was doing the reboot. And then I was like, uh-oh, and then I looked at it, and they added a second Omi for no reason, and they changed all the voice actors except for Tara Strong, because Tara Strong was Omi, if you didn't know. Oh, I think that I found my, damn it, it's of a cheerleader. She is always right there when I need, oh, I think that I found myself a cheerleader. And I got a lot of time to make up ground, that's why I'm not mad. I'm really calm today, maybe because I was able to buy a Switch. Also, I'm kind of upset because fucking, like, I at my work, we sell Nintendo Switches at my place of employment. And we had one left for the longest time. Like, nobody was, like, everyone was, like, on the fence about it. Like, all the people looking at it were like, oh, God, do I want it? And they're like, nah. So, after a while, like, a whole bunch of people called me. Like, I was covering the break of one of the electronics team members. Damn it. And, what happened pretty much was, I got three calls at the same time. They were like, you got any Switches left? I was like, yeah, we got one, and I can't hold it for you. And they're like, oh, damn it. Well, I'll be there as fast as I can. And then, like, immediately after that, like, all five of them showed up the exact same fucking time, including my good friend Travesty. He also showed up with that group of idiots wanting fucking a Nintendo Switch. And I feel so bad because, like, one lady who didn't know anything about video games is able to buy the fucking thing. But yeah, back to my story. With Shaolin Chronicles, the shitty thing is, like, Canadian studio, they could only get Tara Strong. It only lasted, like, seven episodes. And, they, in the Shaolin Showdowns, like, in the original one, it would just go to, like, a cool battle. It'd be like, let's go, Shaolin Showdown! And then all they would do is, it wouldn't even change the art style, it would just, like, build a battle arena for them to fight over the relic. In the reboot, which lasted hardly anything, they went into, like, a shitty CGI, like, 3D art style when they went into Shaolin Showdowns. Why? Who approved that? Some idiot approved that. Damn it. Also, fucking DD was able to get a shield, like, as soon as I blew up. And off we go, Monkey Squad. Dude, Monkey Squad is great. Monkey Squad is bae. Here we go. Just a few more laps of this shit. I also had to clear my hard drive like 8 times, roadies. I'm starting to lose hard drive space like something fierce. I might defrag it in between like my next, you know, recording session with Yeti and Vince and then the next recording session just in general. Oh, yeah. Now we just got Eustace and Dexter to worry about. So he should be good. I love the random monsters blowing up the city in the background of this race. It's so good. Okay, I got one more missile, and I'm saving it. Because I don't know what power-up I'll get if I land on a power-up. And also, DD is right behind me. Good job, Mojo. Oh, shit. Wow. Thank you, DD. Oh, I guess that is Dexter. DD's just the backup. Lol, whoops. They better not reboot Dexter's lab. There's rumors that they were going to. Wow, that was the best shield I ever... Good job, DD. They were trying to reboot Dexter's lab, but the voice actors for Dexter passed, so I don't know if they're gonna do it. They better not. Because when I think of Dexter, I think of, fucking Christine Cavanaugh, who, you know, kicked it. Although Eustace trying to pass me in the last second like a little fucker. It's not what you do, stupid Eustace. You made me look bad. At least Dee Dee has a shield, so she can't, like, shoot missiles at me. And I also have a shield. And, because I used my shield, I paused the wheel on a speed boost, so that's gonna be great. Come on. Yes! Dude, that was the best drift I've ever done. Aha. Dude, the Super Simian shield is really good. I'm gonna use that way more than the speed boost. Thank you so much for the duo suggestion, Callum. This is one of the best squads I've ever seen. I'm digging this squad. Get out of the way, eyeballs. Also, I was also told by Edward that AI can get glitched on the eyeballs, and I think Eustace just got glitched on the eyeballs a little bit. Good job. Man, he's speeding up a little bit, but that's fine. I don't think he'll catch up too fast. Especially if I have a heat-seeking missile and I'm going to get a shield soon. It's fine. Also, I love that adorable little monster. Also, you guys should check out Hot Diggity Demon's review of the Powerpuff Girls reboot, because he explains so many things that are wrong with the reboot of PPG, and it makes me so happy to see that people like are on the same side as me when it comes to most reboots. Samurai Jack reboot, mwah. Danny Phantom reboot, hopefully, mwah. Ben 10 reboot, yeah. PPG reboot, yeah. Teen Titans Go, yeah. You know, a few episodes of Teen Titans Go are funny. I bought the first season of Teen Titans Go on Blu-ray. Don't judge me. Because it was like $15, and why not? Then I can show my kids, eventually when I have children, be like, this is how Teen Titans Go, or Teen Titans was, and then show them good Teen Titans, and I'm like, this is what Teen Titans turned into 10 years later, you know? It'll horribly scar my children when I eventually have children. Ugh. Man, oh man, I am hyped to finish this game. One more race, roadies. Wait. I don't know how long this video was. No. No. More races. I'm stupid. And we'll just do one more race. We'll make this a shorter episode just so we can, you know. So Callum can suggest more characters. So we can do that. Did. Done. 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 This one next. And then we get to jump to the other tracks. And this... Actually, no. This Dexter's track's really short. So I'm just gonna do the Cartoon Eliminator for Dexter's Lab. And I'm gonna do one more. We'll do an extended episode. I don't care, roadies. You guys have earned it. You guys have been loving this Let's Play series, and I appreciate you for giving me views, talking to me, sharing everything you do. Thank you from the pit of my heart. I don't have a heart. I have just a, you know, a concave where my chest should be. It's just a hole right there. I should get a heart. I need to steal someone else's heart. If I eat someone else's heart, do I get their love? Is that how that works? Also, Roadies, what's your favorite cartoon on right now? Like, what is your jam? Comment question of the day. What cartoon do you enjoy watching that's on right now that is currently airing new episodes? That's the only catch. If you're watching a show that got canceled or got series finale'd and you're just watching it again because you love it, cool. But the comment question of the day is, what show are you watching now that whenever a new episode drops, so you're like, yeah! And then you gotta stream that shit or watch that shit live or something. So yeah, for me, it's, of course, Steven, because I love Steven Universe. It's a great show. It destroys boundaries. All the characters are likable, except, like, two of them. I hate Kevin. Kevin's a shitty character. And I hate Yellowtail. Yellowtail's a shitty character. Other than that, all the other characters in that show are good. And then comment question two, what show are you rewatching? So is there a show that you just really like? So for me, I really want to watch Legend of Korra again, because that show is great. I love Legend of Korra. It's a lot better than Avatar The Last Airbender Fight Me, because Avatar The Last Airbender only lasted 3 seasons, and season 3 kind of train wrecked. Legend of Korra lasted 4 seasons. The last season only aired on Nick.com, which is weird, but it ended well. It didn't just train wreck into the ground. It was like, here's a build-up, here's some shit, there's an evil lady trying to make, like, an evil Earth army. Here we go. Fight. And also, Korra is a lesbian, which is cool. I've noticed another weird thing. Not to sound weird, but, like, If couples are gay in, like, TV or in the real world, they're cooler. I don't know why, but, like, half the straight couples I see are like, eh. As a straight guy, I gotta say that straight people are boring. Man, I don't know. If anyone got mad by that, I'm sorry. But as a straight white guy, it's kind of hard to not be offensive. Like, everyone thinks I'm racist because Trump's in office. I really, really hate that. I am, like, super... I'm not super left-wing, but, I mean, I like guns. And, you know, I don't want to go political here, but, like, I am more left-wing than right-wing, and that a Republican's in office and, like, totally destroying half the shit I care about. Like, not to sound weird again, but in the state of wherever I live, you can get weed. And you can get weed for just having a green card. So if you're like, I got asthma, I got the sniffles, I'm depressed, they'll give you weed. And that, like, I think there's, like, an anti-medical marijuana bill trying to get passed by Trump, which is bullshit. Like, I don't smoke I don't eat edibles, but, like, a lot of my friends do. And they've just been so much happier, and their lives have actually been a little bit better since, like, medicinal marijuana has become a thing in my state. So, I mean, why would you repeal that? Damn it! Also, weed is, it's a good thing. Most of my friends who are stoners, like, they're not, like, cranky. They won't, like, attack you. Weed doesn't make you cranky or want to steal. It makes you chill and tell funny stories. That's what weed does. Also, roadies, another controversial topic of NATO potato. What is your least favorite theme song? I know I've made a lot of common questions in this episode. What's your least favorite theme song in a cartoon that you like? So you have to like the show but hate the theme song. And for me, that's a good question. Because there's a lot of shows that I really like the theme song of, and I also really like the show. Chowder. I like that show, and the theme song kind of sucks. What else? What's a show that you remember that nobody else remembers? That's another good comment. And how did Him go so fast? A show that I remember that nobody else remembers is Angela Anaconda. You guys remember that shit? Angela Anaconda was awful. It also spawned the fucking Flash animation craze of the, like, early 2000s. Because Angela Anaconda was a Canadian-made show when they made, like, Flash-animated bodies. And, like, each Flash animated body had a realistic human head. And it was all, like, in the scrapbook art style. And the theme song sucked. But that's just my opinion. Shit. I keep coughing because I keep talking. I should have liquid refreshment up in the game room whenever I'm doing Let's Plays. No, I don't want to review that replay. So now we've done all of the actual cartoon character eliminator races. Time to tackle the other eliminator races, which is the ones that don't take place in a cartoon universe. And we're going to do those in order. Here we go. One more in this episode. I'll record more tomorrow. Here we go. Callum, if you want to tell me new character suggestions, now would be the time. Post it in the comments. Rocky Mountain Trail will be the first one. Days of Blunder. This track is pretty decent. I liked it. And this will be the last one for the episode, roadies. And then I'll, you know, eat some delicious breakfast, and I'll get put together for work. Actually, no, I should probably edit a little bit before I get put together. I don't know, because this is one of... I don't know what's going up today. I think today is a Bomberman co-op with Yeti, and then one of these, so... Yeah, I probably can edit a little bit. I don't know. So I'll probably edit a Bomberman when I get done with this, because that's not going to be hard to edit at all. Like, the Switch really loves my capture card. The PS2 takes a little bit of effort. Half the time it doesn't want to recognize it. Half the time it's like, do you have a console plugged in? And I'm like, yes, I have a console plugged in. No. Oh, shit. Oh, my God. Come on. Oh, my God. Why does he corner so tight? That's what I want to know. You know, I'm bad at this track. Like, just that shortcut, too. Why did it go for mum and not fucking Fuzzy. Oh man, Phlegm's in this. I hate Phlegm. Also, when I was a kid, I thought Phlegm was wearing lipstick. I know that sounds weird, but that's truth. Kind of looks like it. He just has big puffy lips. Which is weird. I don't know. Cow and Chicken was kind of a weird show. It was one of those shows that was spawned in the gross-out era of cartoons and animation when every company wanted to be edgy. So after Ren and Stimpy dropped, they're like, oh my god, we can make dick jokes and poop jokes in a kid's cartoon. Oh my goodness. You know? And then, before you don't know it, hundreds and fifties of shows just showed up out of the woodwork that all had, like, poopy jokes. Which is fine. Also, I got hit by, like, 7 missiles there. Good thing I had my Simian Shield. Simian Shield powers. And I love this corner, because you can just drift around the entire effing thing. Look at this. Look at this drift. Mad drifts, bro. Sick drifts. Also, roadies, if you want, check out some of my friends. Some of my friends that I've met through YouTube and that I've met through other means that are also happening to do YouTube or doing YouTube. So if you want to drop a like or a subscribe, sorry, on any of their any of their channels, if you look at my channel tab, it'll say other great people, and those are the people. Yeah, those are my friends. So we got Vinsanity, we got the Bards, we got Hey Blind Mouse, all really good friends, super nice people, exceptional content. Check them out, please. Also, why did I drift directly into that fucking rock? I am a big dummy. Have you ever woken up and you're like, man, I'm an idiot? I do that all the time. I look at myself in the mirror and I'm like, shit. I'm glad, though. My life's starting to get put together. I'm saving money better. There's a couple of love interests I'm talking to on the daily basis. Hopefully some of them actually, you know, get that I'm hitting on them. Because people who you hit on who either A, don't care, or B, know and aren't going to do anything about it, bugs me a little and, you know, whatever. I'm not going to be salty about it, but I think a few of them, you know, like me back. So if you see, you know, guest specials with gal pals in the future, no, I'm going to hit on a few of them. Some I won't. Like my good friend Jesse, who I pre-ordered the Switch with and I went to the midnight launch with, she's my gal pal, but she's going to stay my gal pal. Again, roadies, if you want to talk like me, gal pal, definition, if you're a straight dude or a lesbian, and you have a friend who's a woman who you don't want to ever have a relationship with other than friend, that is a gal pal. I have a lot of gal pals, which I'm okay with. Gal pals are fine, because they'll teach you how to be a better person, they can hook you up with their friends who are also single, they can, you know, you can just watch TV with them and hang out, which is, oh damn it, which is always good. I like how it says I'm in second, but I'm not really. Oh, man. But yeah, I love talking like me. I want to make t-shirts. I have an affiliation with Spreadshirt.com, and I want to eventually, you know, use that fucking power and release shirts, but I don't know if you guys would buy them, because I only have, like, 150 subs or something. So, honestly, if I'm brutally honest, I don't know anyone who would, like, want to buy a shirt with my face on it or with my name on it or with my logo on it if no one knows who the hell I am. Oh, my God. I don't want to get eliminated. Come on. No, DD. Get out of my laboratory. What does this button do? You know what was weird? When Dexter changed art styles halfway through, and it was pretty much a different show. Oh, man. I hate when they do that. Like, American Dragon Jake Long did the same thing, you know? When, like, all of a sudden it was just in a different art style, and, like, a different crew was working on it. And, like, half the characters either had different voices or looked completely different, but they're like, oh, it's the same character. Hate when companies do that. But whatever, I'm not salty. Oh my god, Dee Dee, what are you doing? Oh, she missed the corner. That's good, and I missed the item box, so that's fine. Ugh, roadies. I am so upset. I have to work 3 p.m. to close shift today. And then tomorrow and the next day I have off, but those are the only days I have off, and I'm hella busy those days. Like, on Wednesday, I'm doing my taxes, and what else am I doing on that day? Doing my taxes, I'm recording, like, 3 hours of or 2 hours of content with myself, just, like, solo content like this. I'm gonna record about an hour with Yeti, and I still have to do all that shit in one day, and then Thursday is gonna double suck. Because, fucking, I have to, you know, I'm gonna hang out with Vinsanity and record some more Shadow Warrior. So that's going to be grand. And then I'm going to... What else am I going to do on Thursday? Oh, yeah, I'm going to do a small grocery run because I don't want to spend a lot of money because this paycheck obliterated my bank account. Like, I know it's none of your business because I don't like saying, like, finances with anyone. Like, literally anyone. Like, I won't even tell my dad if I have, like, financial troubles. I spent $500 on my last payment on my car, so I have another car. That's good because my Buick blew up, as you guys know. If you guys are watching all my Let's Plays, you would know this story. But, so I got a new car. It's not a new car. It's a newish car. It was my brother's old car. So that's good. And then, I think Dee Dee got stuck. Yes. Nice. Oh, now she's unstuck. But I did that, and then I bought the Switch, and then I bought two games with my Switch and two extra Joy-Con pair. So I got the neon bundle for Joy-Cons with my gray bundle console. So I have a red left, blue right, and then a gray combo one. So that's good. I'm hyped. And yeah, I spent all that money, and then I paid phone bill and Wi-Fi bill. And yeah, pretty much now I'm here. So I'm not going to buy anything until I get paid again. Like, I am going to buy those other games that you suggested, Callum. Don't worry, I'll probably be on the next paycheck. But yeah, woohoo! Yes, two incredibly long episodes. Like, holy heck. I didn't think these episodes would be this long. That's okay, the longer the episode, that means the less episodes, right? And that means the quicker you guys will enjoy another Let's Play in this time slot. And on that note, Roadies, on the next installment of Cartoon Network Racing with Some Guy Named Nate, I am going to play more Cartoon Eliminator, we're going to finish all the Cartoon Eliminator tournaments, and then we're going to do Super Tournament, and then we're done with this Let's Play. How many episodes is it going to take? I don't know. I will see you in the next part. I'm sorry if that was creepy.